Hi, I'm Jason.
I'm Jam.
And this is another episode of Podcast for Your Life.
The podcast is so unprofessional. If it was a person, it might think it's a good idea to wear shorts to an interview.
Silly podcast.
Yeah, really is. So
shorts are for kids. Well, what are we talking about today, Jam?
Today, we're going to be talking about journaling.
Oh, nice.
Yep.
Yep. So please get out your pens and papers and let's get to work.
This topic was brought to you by our very own Jason Gress.
Yes. Thank you. This was my idea because I love journaling, as you will find out shortly. Before we do talk about that, what's a journal? Like, what is a journal? Before we talk about journaling, we got to talk about, like, what's a journal?
I think it's a record. I want to say that it should mostly be handwritten, but
yeah,
I don't know if that's actually true anymore, but
yeah, digital people probably use, note-taking apps, or I'm sure there's journaling apps.
Yeah. Yeah. But I would say it's like a personal record to some degree.
Sure.
That's kind of my thought.
Like when we're talking about journaling, it generally means that you're like writing down thoughts in some sort of notepad or a book.
First person kind of way.
Yeah. Yeah. Like talking about how you feel, talking about, you know, notable events in your life. That's generally what we mean by journaling.
This definition ends up excluding any newspaper that decides to include journal in their name. Wall Street Journal.
Oh, right.
Whatever other journals.
The Wall Street Journal started off as just some guy writing his thoughts about Wall Street and money.
Yeah.
And then it just took off.
He accidentally dropped it into the mailbox one day and he was taking his mail.
No, he dropped it on his neighbor's lawn.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
His neighbor was like, man, if only I could get this every day.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He was really frustrated. He'd had a horrible day and he threw it from the street and it threw all his papers.
At somebody's front door.
Journal. Yeah. Yep. Exactly.
And the person who found it was Warren Buffett. Just kidding. All of this is fake. We're not. This is all fake. But anyway, here's the question that I think is a bit controversial, but we need to ask it. Is a journal the same thing as a diary?
I'm going to go with no. How do you feel?
Wow. I don't know. Because growing up, it was. Because there was kind of the idea, at least among, you know, kids, that like diaries are for girls, but boys can also have diaries, but they're not gonna call them diaries because that's too girly. So they're going to call them journals,
which is, that's kind of funny. Cause like, what about writing your thoughts down is girly? Like that's
your diary.
Yeah. That's one of those weird things that like, it doesn't really make sense. Why was that something that we were told or that we came up with?
But I think it's specifically the word. Like,
yeah.
I don't know why diary sounds feminine, but it did when I was a kid.
Yeah.
You know, but nowadays it's like,
it doesn't really sound that way to me, but yeah, I don't know. We think it's like a TV related thing. Cause like,
yeah,
in like, you know, Disney Channel shows or whatever it is, the girls had diaries.
Yeah.
Cause like if that's all, if that's all it is, then that's kind of messed up. Like it's weird. Cause it's the same thing. And who knows how many dudes were like, oh, I'm not going to do that. Cause they saw Lizzie McGuire do it or whatever.
Right. Exactly. So yeah. So growing up I had a journal, AKA a diary.
It's very manly of you.
I think the same thing in this context at least. So
yeah, I think when I said no, I kind of meant like in a lot of ways, I don't know if it has to be. I think diary does have the connotation of like, you write your thoughts down in a pretty personal way. Whereas in a journal, to me, a lot of times it's notes. It could be from a meeting, from a hangout with somebody. It could be things I want to remember, but that's all under the category of journal for me. It could also be thoughts on something, but it's not exclusively that. Like I don't have a entry. It's like, dear diary, today went from good to great.
Okay.
You know?
So diary is kind of like the personal entry about your day versus journal is like, you can just put like, hey, I heard this really good quote today.
Yeah. So and sometimes I've done it like takeaways from something like, man, I had a, you know, meeting with a guy we look up to or whatever. He said some awesome stuff. I want to jot down these like tidbits, these nuggets of good kind of encouraging info or whatever for safekeeping. So there's still the same idea. You want to record it. You want to keep it long-term.
Yeah.
But it feels a lot less like venting. It feels a lot less like spilling your emotions or whatever. But
yeah.
So that's what I usually think of as a journal. It's like, it feels a little less of the personal, but that's just, that's totally a subjective definition.
Sure. Yeah. So, yeah. yeah, my journal has turned into more of that journal you're talking about.
So. Yeah,
but
yeah.
It probably originated as a diary.
So one of my, have you ever heard of the writer Michel de Montaigne, French guy? I could be pronouncing that incorrectly, but Montaigne.
But it sounds fancy.
What people call him most of the time. So he, I learned about him my first year of college, but basically he kind of like popularized the idea of the personal essay, which is not exactly like a diary entry, but similar. Like he would just write, you know, about his life all the time. Mm-hmm. And it was like in these essays that were kind of, you know, topical sometimes or whatever. There was a lot about like self-observing. Mm-hmm. And I remember that being like this kind of renaissance moment for me of like, whoa, journals can be cool. Like,
oh, cool.
This guy, this French guy who lived in centuries ago, wrote all this stuff about his own life. And now we all get to read it. Like, that's pretty cool. Like, I'm never going to be that famous or whatever.
Oui.
But he's famous for like kind of popularizing that idea that like writing about your everyday life could be cool, or there could be some like philosophical value in it. So
yeah,
he's pretty cool. I'd recommend looking at some of his stuff.
That's cool. And I think they also have like a historical value. Like I think historians will go back and read journal entries from famous people or just like your average, you know, farmer in the 1600s and be like, what was life like in, you know, Virginia or whatever?
Yeah. Or so like, you know, I mean, like what would we do if we didn't have diaries of people who are famous or we wouldn't have known about them any otherwise? Like Anne Frank is like, that's a really interesting deal. Like you get to see this window into somebody's life that would we have ever gotten that without those kinds of writings, gotten that perspective? It's like kind of mind blowing.
It is. Cause it's like, you get to be like, for me, it feels like you get to be like kind of the like ghost who's like shadowing another person, you know, like a famous person. Like growing up, I love to read other people's journal stuff. Like there's this, one of my favorite books is basically the journal of Jim Elliot, who is a missionary to Ecuador.
Yeah, I've read that.
And it's great. His book, like one of these books, I think it's called In the Shadow of the Almighty. It's literally just his journal entries, and they vary in length and size and what he talks about. And I just think it's cool because it doesn't feel super polished.
Right.
It may have been polished, but it doesn't feel like super polished.
But it also doesn't feel like dramatic either. Like,
yeah, there's no, like people in their normal lives, even somebody who's like going to a, you know, remote tribe in the middle of the jungle still just doesn't feel super dramatic, whatever.
Yeah.
I like that. I just kind of like seeing like what people are thinking, like what they encountered in their life, like what just random things that come up. Cause when I go back and read my journal, I see kind of not similar stuff. Like I'm not comparing myself to these guys, but I do see like, oh, when I was 10 years old, that's what I was thinking about. Or when I was 20 years old, that's what I was thinking about.
And it's cool because like you're saying, it's not polished. So it doesn't feel like how autobiographies can feel like this very prepared, trimmed down version of somebody's life, whatever.
Right, yeah.
But like just hearing it from them, like, hey, here's the significant things that made me write down my thoughts on paper or whatever. It's kind of amazing. And I feel like it's a kind of a lost art. Not to everybody, but like to the everyday person. I don't know if we know how to like write down our thoughts about life without it.
Spew them on Facebook.
Yeah. On Facebook, or knowing how to do that in a way that would be helpful to us in the future.
Yeah.
And or doesn't seem like the dear diary.
Yeah.
Like we don't really know another model of how to do it.
Yeah.
It'd be kind of cool if we did. I really liked trying to figure out a way to do this in my life. And I'm kind of in the middle of it right now. I don't really know the best way. I've toyed with trying to do a digital journal. Partly because like, I feel like I might just keep up with it better. But then I've also recently messed with like doing an audio one, recording voice memos. One, it's easy. A lot less like barriers to like, I don't have to sit down and like prepare it or whatever. And I did actually that on a trip with our work before when I was in a different country. And I would just do a daily download on when I would go on those trips on a little recorder. It just helped so much to be able to recall real quick into that. It's at the end of the day, you're tired. It's how that is, even if you're not overseas somewhere. It's like at the end of the day, trying to write your thoughts down is not always the best move.
Yeah.
But just saying them into a recorder, super easy.
Yeah.
And so I've thought like many things that I wish I had probably done that with and recorded them in some way, because otherwise it kind of drops off your RAM. so to speak.
And then you can hear your voice change over the years too.
That's true.
You're like, dear diary.
But I think it does feel a little bit like, I feel a little too self-conscious sometimes trying to do it.
Hmm. Interesting. I think the cool part about journaling is that you get to like talk to something that's not going to talk back to you. And it's just like a perfect endless listening. Mm-hmm. You know, and it's like we do need people to share stuff with, but sometimes it is nice to be like, I don't necessarily need a response. I just kind of want to talk about how I'm feeling or whatever. So
yeah,
so I thought it'd be fun to read some of my earliest journal entries. I got my first and only journal when I was, quote, 9 and about 2.5 months old.
Oh, nice. So two and a half months.
I literally wrote it down. Also, my penmanship back then was flawless.
Dang.
Isn't it funny, like, when you see yourself and, man, what happened to that guy? He has such great handwriting.
Gosh, that's interesting.
All right. So here's my first ever journal entry. What a day. We went to the batting cages and bumper boats. It was fun. I went fishing and some little striped bass nibbled on my lure. There were little hermit crabs working right by me. Me and Dad are going fishing tomorrow morning. I hope I have fun. Last year, we went to the tuna boats. The tunas were huge. They looked yummy, too. We went to the beach today. It was packed. And then I talk about my age. So that's my first one. There you go. Historic. If I ever become famous, then you can publish that.
People will be like, wow, he was just like us.
Yep. And basically, I was given the journal as a gift when we were on vacation in Cape Cod, Massachusetts, when I was 9 and 2.5 months years old. So, and then fast forwarding a little bit, some of the things that we talked about that I was like thankful for was that I was diligent in school. So I'm like thankful for diligence.
Yeah. You're like, I'm thankful that I'm good. I'm good.
Yep. I was also thankful for kindness. I think that was from me. Like, I'm so glad that I'm kind. I was thankful for the year 2004. I don't know why.
It was a pretty good year.
Yep. And then my favorite one is I was thankful for my abilities, which is like, again, really prideful. But the best part is that I misspelled abilities. So it's like, I'm so thankful for my abilities.
How do you spell it?
I spelled it with two B's.
Right. Abilities.
So it's ironic because it's like, yeah, buddy, you need to go home and work on your spelling abilities.
Dude, that is great.
So there you go. Journaling for your life.
That's great. Yeah. I didn't bring my journal, but I can tell you for sure that like one of my highest journaling periods was when I was like late freshman, early sophomore in college. And a big part of that was a lot of dramatic thoughts about the girl that I liked and wanted to date and that kind of thing.
Oh yeah.
And it's so funny how like we run to something like, I got to write these thoughts down.
Yeah.
And they're pretty dramatic. I mean, it's kind of fun to have them because that's who I ended up marrying is my wife now. But
yeah, that's awesome.
It's kind of funny to look back on, but it's also so, so hard to read. I'm it's just so cringy.
Yeah.
Gosh.
I also find it kind of amusing though. Like I have some journal entries when I was like 10 where I was like so serious about marriage, even though you're like 10 years old. It's like, what do you know? One thing that was like, I was playing on the playground today and I found myself standing next to this girl. And just for a moment, I thought this could be the girl I'm marrying.
Like, you put a lot of pressure on yourself.
Yeah, for real. I'm like, I was 10. What was I thinking?
Man.
But seriously, I wrote that in my journal.
You're like, such a grown-up 10-year-old, dude. That's incredible. Oh, my gosh.
So, yeah, I was pretty serious about things back then. So
wow.
Yeah, but it's just funny to read journals. So you guys have to let us know some of your funny or even embarrassing journal memories.
Yeah.
And definitely comment on our Facebook post when this episode goes live and let us know some fun, or just email us at podforyourlife@gmail.com. And we'd love to hear them. Cause again, it's one of my favorite things is reading other people's.
And I'll post one too. Cause it seems kind of unfair that you shared one.
Yes.
Like straight up. And I just kind of alluded to one. So that's a little more fair. I'll post one too. And I won't pick the least embarrassing one. I'll make sure it's a good
the
one.
The second least embarrassing one.
Yeah. Well, that is all the time we have today, but thank you guys so much for listening.
Yeah.
Thanks Jason for suggesting this topic. Jason in Texas, I think.
McKinney, Texas specifically.
Yep. And we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.